Hello everyone, welcome back to Nagesh Karajki Worker School. Dear students, in our last session we have seen how to do the multiplication of money. Now today we are going to see how to do the division of money. So open your textbook, page number 43. Look at the board here, division of money. We will take one example. Mom had rupees 75. She divided it equally among her three children. How much money did each child get? See students, first of all I have to tell you what is mean by division. Division means what? Splitting the things in equal groups, that is called as division. Now here mom had rupees 75 and that 75 rupees she want to divide equally among her three children, and the question is how much money did each child get. So here what you have to do, 75 divided by 3. Okay, see here, 75 divided by 3. Normally how you have done the division in division lesson, how you have learned how to do the division in that lesson, in the similar way only you have to do the division of money. Okay, see here, mom had 75 rupees and that 75 rupees she want to divide in among her three children equally. So 75 by 3 we have to do. Okay, now see here, in 75 we have to start from the 7. So 7 by 3 first we have to do, 7 divided by 3. Now you have to see the table of 3. In the table of 3, can you see the number 7? No, 7 is not there. Then you have to see the smaller number than 7. Yes, which number is there smaller than 7? 6 is there. So 3 twos are 6. 3 twos are 6. Okay. Now here what you have to do? You have to do the subtraction, that is 7 minus 6 you have to do. 7 minus 6, 1. Okay. Now here we have done first step. Now we will do the second step. In the second step, this 5 we have to take down. So here when we will take this 5 down, here we will get 15. Okay. Now here we have 15. Now again you have to see the table of 3. In table of 3, can you see the number 15? Yes. 3 5s are 15. 3 5s are 15. Now 15 minus 15, 0. So what quotient we got here? 25. Quotient means what? This answer is called as quotient. Yes. And this is the, yes, dividend, and this is divisor, and this is remainder. Okay. So what quotient we got here? 25. Okay. So what is the answer? 25. So each child got rupees 25. Okay, clear? Okay. Now let us solve the next exercise, that is exercise 3.7. See the first example, rupees 36.9. Yes, rupees 36.9. Okay, how will you solve this? Same like a division, same how you have learned in the division lesson, in that way only you have to do the division of money. So rupees 36.9, first example, rupees 36 by 9. Okay, now see here, 36 by 9. See here, in 36, 3 is first number. So here 3 by 9 we can't do because 3 is smaller than 9. So now here we have to take this both the numbers together, 36. 36 by 9. Now in the table of 9, you have to see the number 36. 36 number is there? Okay. 36 is there. Now in 36, how many 9s are there? Yes, say the table of 9. Yes, in the table of 9, sorry, in 36 there are 4 9s. Okay, 9 4s are 36. 9 4s are 36. Yes, 9 4 36. So 36 minus 36, yes, 0. So here rupees 36 by 9 is equal to what? Rupees 4. Okay, this 36 rupees, if we have to divide among 9 children, then each child will get 4 rupees. In this way you can solve this division. Okay, now we'll move to the second example. Rupees 63.7. Second number, rupees 63 by 7. Okay, now here arrange the number in this way, 63 divided by 7. Now here again, see this first number, 6 is smaller than 7. So here 6 by 7 we can't do. So what you are going to do then? 63 by 7. Okay, here we have to take both the numbers together. 63 divided by 7. Now you have to see the table of 7. Can you see the number 63 in the table of 7? Yes. Yes, correct. Yes, say the table of 7. 7 9s are 63. So write here 9. 7 9s are 63. 7 9s are 63. Now 63 minus 63, 0. So rupees 63 by 7 is equal to rupees 9. Okay, understood how to solve? Okay. Then we'll move to the next, third example, that is rupees 40 by 4. Rupees 40 by 4. It is very easy. 40 by 4. Now see the table of 4. 40 number is there. 4 tens are 40. 4 tens are 40. Or else you can do in this way also. 4 ones are 4. So 4 minus 4, 0. Then you have to take this 0 down. So here now we have 0. So 4 into 0, 0. So here 4 tens are 40. So 40 divided by 4 is equal to 10. So here you have to write the answer 10. Okay, clear? Okay. Now see the fourth number example. What is the question? Rupees 55 divided by 5. 55 divided by 5. Yes, arrange the numbers in this way. Now here, students, what is the dividend here? Yes, 55. And what will be the divisor here? 5 is the divisor. Okay, now see in 55 first number is 5. Okay, so first of all we will do 5 by 5. 5 ones are 5. Now 5 minus 5, 0. Now next step, in the next step what you are going to do? Yes, in the next step this 5 we have to take it down. So take 5 down here. Okay, now here we have 5. Again 5 ones are 5. Now 5 minus 5, 0. Okay, so 55 by 5 is equal to 11. So rupees 55 divided by 5 is equal to rupees 11. Okay. Now we'll move to the fifth example, fifth number, rupees 204 by 6. Rupees 204 by 6. Okay, now arrange the numbers. Now here we have 3 digit number, that is 204 by 6. Okay, now see here the first number 2 is smaller than 6. So here 2 by 6 we can't do. So for that what we will do? We will take these two numbers together, that is 20 by 6 first we will do. Okay, now see the table of 6. Can you see that number 20 in table of 6? No, 20 is not there. Then we have to find out the smaller number than 20. Which number is there smaller than 20? 18, correct. So in 18, how many 6 are there? In 18, there are 3 6. Okay, so 6 3 is 18. 6 3 is 18. Okay, now 20 minus 18. 20 minus 18. 20 minus 18, 2. Okay, now we'll move to the second step. In the second step, what you are going to do? In the second step, this 4 will come down. Okay, in the second step, this 4 will come down. Now here we have 24. Now again, you have to see the table of 6. In the table of 6, can you see the number 24? Yes, 24 is there. Okay, now in 24, how many 6 are there? Yes, how many 6 are there in 24? 4. 6 4 is 24. 6 4 is 24. Now 24 minus 24, 0. Okay, so rupees 204 by 6 is equal to rupees 34. Okay, clear, understood? Okay. Now we'll move to the sixth number. Rupees 240 by 4. Rupees 240 by 4. Now first we will arrange the numbers in this format. Rupees 240 by 4. Now see this 240. It is a 3-digit number. See the first number. Here 2 is there. 2 by 4. Can we do 2 by 4? No. 2 by 4 we can't do because here 2 is smaller than 4. So in this case, we have to take these two numbers together. 24 by 4 we have to do. Okay. Now see the table of 4. In the table of 4, 24 number is there? Yes, 24 is there. In 24, how many 4s are there? Yes. 4, 6 are 24. Yes, 4, 6 are 24. Say, 4, 6 are 24. Now 24 minus 24. 24 minus 24, 0. Okay. Now next step. In the next step, the 0 will come down. Okay. So here we have 0 only. So 4, 0, 0. So rupees 240 by 4 is equal to rupees 60. So here you have to write the answer, rupees 60. Okay, clear? Okay, now see the seventh number example. Rupees 256 by 8. 256 by 8. Now see again, 2 is smaller than 8, so 2 by 8 we can't do. So in this case, what we are going to do, here we are going to take these two numbers together, that is 25 by 8. Okay, now you have to see the table of 8, because here the divisor is 8. See the table of 8. Can you see the number 25? No, 25 is not there. So see the smaller number than 25. Which is the smaller than 25? 24 is there. So in 24, how many 8s are there? There are 3 8s. So 8 3 is 24. 8 3 is 24. Okay. Now 25 minus 24. 25 minus 24, 1. So write here 1. Now step 2. In step 2, what you are going to do? This number you have to take down. Now here 6 will come down. So here we have now 16. 16 by 8. 16 by 8. See the table of 8. 8 2 is 16. Correct. So write here 2. 8 2 is 16. Now 16 minus 16, 0. Okay. So rupees 256 by 8 is equal to rupees 32. Clear? How to solve this seventh number example? Okay. Now we'll move to the next example, that is eighth one. Rupees 372 by 4. Rupees 372 by 4. Now arrange the numbers. 372 by 4. Again, in the 372, 3 is smaller than 4. So here 3 by 4 we can't do. So what we will do? 37 by 4 first we will do. Okay, 37 by 4. Now in table of 4, in the table of 4, 37 number is not there. So we will find out the smaller number than 37. 36 is there. Okay, now in 36, how many 4s are there? Yes, in 36 how many 4s are there? 4 9s are 36. So here we will write 9. 4 9s are 36. 4 9s are 36. Now 37 minus 36, 1. So write here 1. Okay. Now step 2. In step 2, this number we have to take down. Okay. Whatever number is there here in the next place, that number will come down. So here this 2 will come down. Now here we have 12. 12 by 4 we have to do. 12 by 4. Okay. Now in 12, how many 4s are there? 4 3s are 12. So here we will write 3. 4 3s are 12. 4 3s are 12. Now 12 minus 12, 0. 12 minus 12, 0. So what will be the answer? Rupees 93. Rupees 372 by 4 is equal to rupees 93. Clear? Understood? Okay. Now see the ninth number example. Read the numbers. Rupees 363 by 3. Now arrange the numbers. 363 by 3. Now see the first number in 363. 3 is there. 3 by 3. 3 ones are 3. 3 ones are 3. Now 3 minus 3, 0. Now step 2. In step 2, this 6 will come down. Okay. Now in 6, how many 3s are there? 2. 3 2s are 6. 3 2s are 6. Now 6 minus 6, 0. Now next step, step 3. In the next step, this 3 will come down. Okay. So take this 3 down here. Now in 3, how many 3s are there? 1. Okay. So 3 1s are 3. 3 minus 3, 0. So rupees 363 by 3 is equal to rupees 121. Okay, clear? Okay. Now see the next example, that is 10th number. Rupees 224 by 7. Rupees 224 by 7. Now first of all arrange the numbers. 224 by 7. Okay. Now in 224, 2 is smaller than 7. So here 2 by 7 we can't do. So what we will do now? Yes, we will take 22 by 7. First we will do 22 by 7. Okay. Now see the table of 7. In the table of 7, can you see the number 22? Yes, 22 is not there. Then we will find out the smaller number than 22. Okay, smaller than 22, 21 is there in the table of 7. Okay, now in 21, how many 7s are there? 7 3s are 21. 7 3s are 21. Okay, now 22 minus 21, 1. 22 minus 21, 1. Okay. Now we'll move to the next step. In the next step, this 4 will come down. So here, now we have 14. Now in 14, how many 7s are there? 7 2s are 14. 7 2s are 14. Okay. Now 14 minus 14, 0. 14 minus 14, 0. Okay, so rupees 224 by 7 is equal to rupees 32. Clear? Understood how to solve? Okay. Now we'll move to the next example, that is 11th number. Rupees 498 by 6. Rupees 498 by 6. Now arrange the numbers. 498 by 6. Now here, what is the dividend? 419. And what is the divisor? 6. Now in 498, 4 is the first number. Okay. Now here 4 by 6. Can we do 4 by 6? No, we can't do. So what we will do first? We will take these two numbers together. That is 49 by 6 we have to do. Okay. Now see the table of 6. Can you see the number 49? 49 is there in the table of 6? No. 49 is not there. So find out the smaller number than 49. Yes, 48 is there. Okay. Now in 48, how many 6 are there? Yes, see the table of 6. 6 8 is 48. 6 8 is 48. 6 8 is 48. Now 49 minus 48, 1. 49 minus 48, 1. Okay. Now we'll move to the next step. In the next step, this 8 will come down. Okay. So here we have 18. Here we have 18. 18 by 6. 18 by 6. Now in the table of 6, 18 is there? Yes, 18 is there. Now in 18, how many 6 are there? In 18, there are 3 6. 6 3 is 18. 6 3 is 18. Now 18 minus 18, 0. 18 minus 18, 0. So rupees 498 by 6 is equal to what? Rupees 83. So here you have to write the answer, that is rupees 83. Now students, see the 12th number example, that is rupees 200 by 5. 200 by 5. Now arrange these number in the format. Now what is the dividend? Here 200 is the dividend. And what is the divisor? 5 is the divisor. Now see here in 200, first number is 2. First digit is 2. Now here 2 by 5 we can't do because 2 is smaller than 5. So in this case what we have to do? Here we have to take these two numbers together. So 20 by 5 first we have to do. 20 by 5. Now in the table of 5, can you see the number 20? Yes, 20 is there. Now in 20, how many 5s are there? 5 4s are 20. So we have to write here 4. 5 4s are 20. Okay, 5 4s are 20. Now 20 minus 20, 0. Here we have to do the subtraction. 20 minus 20, 0. Okay. Now next step, step number 2. In the step 2 we have to take this 0 down. Okay, so here we have 0. So 5 0 0 5 0 0. So here we have to write 0, then 0 minus 0, 0 only. So rupees 200 by 5 is equal to rupees 40. Understood? Okay. Now see the next example, that is 13th number. Read the number. Rupees 480 by 8. Rupees 480 by 8. Now in the dividend, first number is 4 and what is the divisor? 8. Okay. What is the divisor? 8. Now 4 by 8. Can you do 4 by 8? No. We can't do 4 by 8. Why? Because 4 is smaller than 8. So what we will do? Yes. We will take these two numbers together. 48 by 8. 48/8. Okay, now see the table of 8 and you have to say the table of 8. Okay, see in the table of 8, can you see the number 48? Yes, 48 is there. Okay, in 48 how many 8s are there? Yes, 6 8s are there. Okay, so 8 6 are 48. Say along with me, 8 6 are 48. Now 48 minus 48 0. Okay, now next step. In the next step, whatever number is there, that number we have to take it down. Now here we have 0, so we will take that 0 down. So here we have 0. 8 0 0 8 0 0. So here 0 minus 0 0. Okay, so rupees 480/8 is equal to rupees 60. Okay, clear? In this way you have to solve this example. Now we'll move to the next example, that is 14th number. Rupees 747/9. Rupees 747 by 9. Rupees 747/9. Now first arrange this number. Shall I write this first? Okay. Again we will take the same example, that is 747 by 9 is equal to, this is 14th number. Okay, so first we will arrange these numbers, 747 by 9. Now see students, here divisor is 9. And here in the dividend, first is 7 number, 7 is smaller than 9, so 7 by 9 we can do. So here we will take this 74 together. Now in the table of 9, can you see the number 74? 74 is not there. So just you have to find out the smaller number than 74. Yes, which one is the smaller than 74? 72 is there. Okay, now in 72, how many 9s are there? 9 8s are 72. Now 74 minus 72 2. Now next step. In the next step, this 7 will come down. So here we have 27 now. Now in 27, how many 9s are there? Yes, 9 3s are 27. So 27 minus 27 0. So rupees 747/9 is equal to what? Rupees 83. So here you have to write the answer, rupees 83. Okay, now we'll move to the 15th number example. What is the example? Rupees 328/2. Okay, now see the table of 2. 3 is not there, so 2 1s are 2. Where is it? Is 2 1s are 2. Now 3 minus 2 1. Now step 2, in the step 2 this 2 will come down. So here we have 12. In 12 how many 2s are there? 2 6s are 12. Now 12 minus 12 0. Now step 3, in the step 3 this 8 will come down. Okay, now here 2 is there and here it is there, means 8/2 we have to do. 2 4 is 8. 8 minus 8 0. So 328/2 is equal to rupees 164. Okay, now the last example is remaining, that is 16th number. Rupees 889/7. 889/7. Now see the number here in the dividend 889 and the divisor is 7. First of all, you have to do 8 by 7. Yes, 7 ones are 7. 7 ones are 7. 8 minus 7, 1. Now we'll move to the next step. In the step 2, this 8 will come down. So write here 8. Now here we have 18. Now see the table of 7. Can you see the number 18? 18 is not there. So what we will do? Yes, we will find out the smaller number than 18. Which is the smaller number than 18? 14 is there. Okay. 7 2's are 14. 7 2's are 14. Now 18 minus 14? 4. 18 minus 14? 4. Okay. Now we'll move to the next step. That is third step. In the third step, this number will come down. Here 9 is there. So we will take this 9 down. So here we have now 49. Okay. Now see the table of 7. Can you see the number 49? Yes, 49 is there. Okay. When it is 7 sevens are 49. 7 sevens are 49. Now do the subtraction. 49 minus 49. 0. Okay. So rupees 889 by 7 is equal to what? Rupees 127. Okay. So in this way, today we have seen how to do the division of money, and also we have completed exercise 2.7. In the next session, we will see the remaining part. Till that time, take care. Thank you.